Hello my dear viewers, welcome back to Pritha's Cooking House. My today's recipe is fish chop. This is a very famous Indian snacks recipe, or you can say this is very famous Kolkata snacks recipe, and this recipe requires very minimal ingredients. So let's get started, and all the ingredients details are below there in the description box. Please have a look. And if you are new here in my channel and have not yet subscribed my channel, then please subscribe it and hit the bell icon to get regular updates regarding my recipes. And if you like the recipe, then please like the video, share the video with your family and friends, and comment on the below comment section. Now for making the fish chop, I have taken here around 650 grams to 700 grams of rohu fish pieces, and I have marinated these fish pieces with some turmeric powder and salt as per taste for around 20 minutes. And you can definitely use katla fish or bhetki fish or any other choice of your fish apart from rohu fish as well. And now I have taken one karhai or frying pan, and I have added some refined oil into it. And when the oil is well heated, we need to put the fish pieces, marinated fish pieces, into the heated oil and need to fry the fish pieces very well. So after 3 minutes we can see that the one side of the fish pieces are fried well, and now we need to turn the fish pieces to the other side. So basically both the sides needs to be fried well. For fish chop, we don't require a very crispy fish fry, just normal fish fry will be okay for fish chop. After another 3 minutes we can see that the fish pieces are well fried now. I mean, these are perfect for fish chop. This texture is perfect for fish chop. Now at this point of time we need to take it out from the oil. Now keep the fish pieces aside for around 30 to 40 minutes and let it be cool. After 30 minutes I am back, and now the fish pieces are in room temperature. And now at this point of time we need to remove all the fish bones from the fried fish pieces. So there shouldn't be any fish bones. We need to remove all the fish bones very well. So with the help of your hand you need to do this, and so the way I am doing this, you need to follow the same procedure. Now see, I have removed all the fish bones from the fried fish pieces. Now with the help of your hand, you need to mash this fish very well. After mashing the fish, the texture should be like this. And now for the binding of the chop, we need to add some potatoes into it. I mean some boiled potatoes. So I have used here 2 medium sized boiled potatoes. Don't use too much potatoes, then the taste will be more like aloo chop than the fish chop. So just use a little bit of boiled potatoes just for the binding. So after adding the boiled potatoes, again mash it with the fish pieces. We need a very smooth texture out of it, so mash it very well. Now take a frying pan or karhai and add around 1.5 tablespoons of oil into it. And when the oil will be well heated, add some sliced onion. I have used here 1 medium size onion slice, and need to fry them until the raw smell of onion goes away. After 3 minutes of frying the onion, the raw smell is not coming out anymore. Now at this point of time we need to add some ginger garlic paste. So I have added here around 1 tablespoon ginger paste and 2 tablespoon garlic paste into it, and we'll give it a quick mix. and we'll wait until the raw smell of ginger and garlic goes away. After another 2 to 3 minutes, now we can see that no raw smell of ginger and garlic is coming out anymore. So now at this point of time, we need to add the mashed fish and boiled potato mixture into it. After adding the mixture into the karhai, we need to give it a very good mix. After mixing it well, now we need to add some spices into it. So I have added here some red chili powder, around 2 teaspoon red chili powder I have added. And after adding the red chili powder, need to give it a very good mix again. Now we will be adding some salt as per taste, as we have already added salt while marinating the fish pieces. So now at this point of time, don't add too much of salt, just use a bit of salt as per taste. And then we will be adding some chopped coriander leaves for a nice flavor. So I have added here around 1 tablespoon chopped coriander leaves. And then finally we will be adding the last ingredient of our fish chop stuffing, that is garam masala. So I have added here around 2 teaspoon garam masala powder into it. And after adding the garam masala powder, we need to give it a very good mix again. After mixing all the ingredients very well, our fish chop stuffing looks perfect, the texture looks perfect. So now at this point of time, we need to put off the gas and need to keep this aside and let it be cool. In the meantime, I have taken one bowl and I have added here around 2 tablespoon corn flour and 2 tablespoons maida or all-purpose flour into it. Then we'll be adding some salt as per taste into it. And then finally we need to add some red chili powder. We'll give it a quick mix. After mixing it, we'll add some water into it and we'll make a smooth slurry out of this. We'll add some more water and we'll give it a quick mix. The texture of the slurry should be like this. So this is the perfect texture for this slurry. Now we need to assemble all the things. For that I have taken a small portion of the fish chop stuffing which we have made and kept aside earlier, and we'll give it a shape. You can give it a round shape or oval shape or any shape as per your choice. I'm giving it a shape like this. And after giving it a shape, we need to put them into the corn flour and all-purpose flour slurry which we have made earlier. So just put them into the slurry and coat it well. After coating it well into the slurry, next we need to put them into the breadcrumbs and need to coat them with the breadcrumbs very well, because the crispiness of the fish chop will be depends on the breadcrumbs coating only. So this coating needs to be very well. So for your better understanding, I'm just repeating this step. So just take a small portion of the fish chop stuffing and then give it a nice shape as per your choice. And after shaping it, just put it into the corn flour and all-purpose flour slurry which we have made. And then coat it into the breadcrumbs. So like this, all the fish chops needs to be prepared. I mean the coating of the fish chops needs to be done like this. And after all the fish chop coating is done, we need to keep them into refrigerator for around 20 minutes so that it will be well set. After 20 minutes, the fish chops are well set and we have taken it out from the refrigerator. Now we need to deep fry the fish chops. So for that, I have taken one karhai or frying pan and I have added here around 6 to 7 tablespoons of refined oil. And when the oil is well heated, we need to add the very well coated and very well set fish chops into the oil and need to fry them. With the help of a spatula or spoon, put some oil on the upper surface of the fish chop like this and need to fry them very well. So after 3 to 4 minutes, we need to turn the fish chop to the other side because both the sides needs to be very well fried and we need to deep fry the fish chops because we need a very crispy texture out of it. So turn it to the other side and fry the other side very well as well. Both the sides are well fried now. The color has been changed as well and the texture also looks perfect, very crispy. Now at this point of time, our fish chops are completely ready to be served. So take it out from the oil and serve them hot with some salad and sauce. Hope you liked my recipe. We'll be back very soon with a new recipe. Till then, bye.